Ciao YouTube, I'm the Kaz and this is the Kaz Does, the unconventional DIY YouTube channel. This is video part 2 of my mini series about my lighting system and how it's built. So let's get into it. As I said, this is my second video about my lighting system, the light system that I just built from scratch in my den. If you didn't see video 1, go check it up here. And yeah, in this video we will talk about how I dimension my wiring system, how I design it for building all the tube stuff. But first, as I said in my previous video, I want to show you the lamp that I choose for my den, for my video making den. So let's go on the car in the den. See you later. These are the two type of lamps that I choose for light my den. If you didn't follow all the process, just be sure to check the link up in the corner for see how I design all my lighting system. The first one, the LED tubes, I have 22 of them and they're made by Viva, that's a brand that sells all around Europe. You cannot find this kind of tube on Amazon. I didn't like, you know, it was really tough to find them. I find it in a very big light store in Rome. And they have a huge amount of CRA, it's 97, for 1500 lumens and just a power consumption on 18 watts. These other ones, these huge LED bulbs, these lamps I brought it from Amazon, they provide a huge amount of lights. They are 100 watts of power consumption, they can provide 13,000 lumen, and they have a CRA value higher than 80, so even a quite good one. Not the best, but using both, I will have a very good like color viewing, so that's perfect. I hope that the Kaz explained you whatever information that he got in the best way he could. But anyways, if there is something that you didn't understand, just leave a comment in the section comment below. We will reply you, don't worry about it. And now, why we are home? Because we need our PC. We need our computer for design our wiring system. But before to get into that, I need to explain you something that you need to know about the wiring system. To dimension properly a wiring system, the only thing that you need to know, it's one law. EB lower than EN lower than EZ, where EB is the current of your load, EN is the limit current of your safety switch, EZ is the current that your wire can support. But we will go deeply into each of these arguments in a while. Let's start from EB. As I told you, the lamp that I choose is an 18 watt power consumption lamp. In Europe, our voltage system is 240 volts, so to find how many amps one lamp will suck from the net, we just divide power per voltage, so it's 18 divided per 240, it's something about 0.07 amps. Now we have the current on one single load. We need to multiply for every load that we plug together at the same safety switch. In my case, I have a maximum 12 lamps on one safety switch. So we multiply 0.07 per 12 and we will find the total current of our load. This value needs to be lower than EN. As we said, EN is the safety switch current limit. This current is usually wrote on the safety switch. See? That 16 means 16 amps. So we have 16 amp of EN and we have 0.075 per 12. 0.075 per 12, it's 0.9. That's quite lower than EN, so we're good to go. Now we need to check that our EZ is higher than our EN. EZ, as we said, is the current that your wire can support, but this needs a little bit math. EZ, in fact, it doesn't just depend on your wire sides. It depends even on how your wiring system is built and at which temperature max will work. This build factor and temperature factor will affect the calculation of your EZ. In fact, EZ is the multiplication of your wire side's maximum current, your K1, that's your temperature factor, and your K2, that's your out-of-build factor. You multiply these three factors together and you will find your correct EZ. So let's make an example for make it clear. I use it for one inch lamp, 1.5 millimeter square cable. I don't know what size it's in English, but you know, it can support 14.5 amps if the cable is passed through the wall at working temperature max of 25 degrees. But I didn't pass the cable to the wall. I passed the cables outside the walls in tubes. In that case, K2 change. So my 1.5 millimeter square cable at 25 degrees maximum working temperature can reach 16.5 amps. So this 3 amps difference is just because the system is built different. You can find these two factors, K1 and K2, in tables that will be attached in my video description, so you can understand what I mean, and you can even use it for your purpose too. In Europe, and even in Italy, so you cannot build your wirings and your electrical system by yourself. You need a certified electrician to do it, because all the wiring system has to be certified. If you cannot produce a certification, you cannot do it. That simple. I asked my electrician if he wants me to film him while he was doing his job, but the problem is that he's a very shy guy. He didn't want to stay in video. So I'm sorry, but I cannot let you see how my cabinet, my boxes, and all my wiring was cabled. So I really apologize for this, I'm sorry, but I hope that you will find useful anyways my information. Anyway, doing all the boring job, like make holes, place tubes, boxes, design the backbones, all these kind of things, it will get his job really easy and my paycheck very low. Now let's go on the PC and see how to design the wiring needed to your lighting system. Woo! First step, open my floor plan. The second step is to make layers for get the design organized. I know the dimension of my lamps. It's 1.2 meters per 0.1 meter. Now I know their position half meter from this wall, so I will move it. And they are positioned 40 centimeters from the column, so let's do this too. Now I want to mirror it from the center of the wall. And I want to do the same things for this lower part of my bigger working area. Let's mirror even on the right side of the wall, the lamps that we just designed. I'm using this constructing line to do it. Now I will draw another constructing line for copy this column of lamps in the center of my main working area. Here it is. I will do the same things in this lower part. And there we are. First step result. Now I will add the central lamps. In the main working area, they will be composed by the huge LED bulb. So they will be designed as a square. And I'm using this constructing line for place them in the best way. And I will do the same like this, but here I will use LED tubes instead of LED bulbs. So now let's design the LED bulbs. Here it is, let's change layers. Boom, done. Same process with these ones. And this is, I know that this will be like the layout of my lighting system because the Dialux told me this. Now I want to make another layer for the Junction boxes. Let's make it green. Now that we make the first one, let's make another layer for the lamps backbones. Let's design it on red. Here it is. Now, Let's copy this configuration where needed. I will also need this type of configuration for these lamps and these other ones. So let's do it. Let's adjust the design first. And now let's copy this. And adjust this configuration here. Now, for this central line of lamps, this one and this other one, I will place a junction box it on this central column and this central column, and I will plug these lamps to these junction boxes that I want to design. You will see it. Now, as you can see, all the lamps are connected to at least one junction box. So what we have to do now is design the main electrical cabinet, or at least where to place it, and go from the main electrical cabinet to the main junction boxes, and from the main junction boxes to these little junction boxes. So let's do it. Let's make another layer. So I want to place it, the main cabinet here at the entrance. So and now I want to place two main junction boxes, one here and the other one here. That's because this one will connect all the lamps on the right side of my den, and this one in the center will connect the left side of my den, and even the central one, and the switches that will stay in this column right here. So let's do it. We got it. Now let's make another layer for the main backbones. I want to pass around all these columns. This will help me consider the longer way that the wires and the tubes needs to do. And now the last and main part that will go from the main junction boxes to the main cabinet. Now we have all the lamps joined together with their own single junction boxes. All the junction boxes plug it together to the main junction boxes, and then the main junction boxes plug it to the main cabinet. So what will I do now? I will add instruction list on the right side of the design, so you can download it and you will understand better, even if there is something that you didn't get it yet. So see you.